Good morning. After many requests, we decided to make a new series about Chi Sao. Chi Sao is the best method through which one can learn Wing Chun. For this reason, we will show you how to study every movement, otherwise there is no way you will learn Wing Chun. But let me clarify that Chi Sao is a deep study and not a battle. So, don't pay attention to masters who kick their students' asses or to those who move their hands fast as if they are demon-possessed. Because when you go into an actual combat, all these disappear and you are left with nothing. At the end of each set of movements, we will analyze how Chi Sao is applied into an actual fight. To begin with, let's create a random example. Okay, that was fast. Let's study it. I try to enter using my tansao. As you can see, I am entering using my hips, which means my structure. Correspondingly, my opponent needs to develop his structure, developing a correct foxao and also keep a correct line to my center. Otherwise, he will collapse and he is finished. He must also cut my line to the center using a jam saw. If he loses the central line, I have to immediately realize that there is another line open for me and I have to take it. Bam! And this is very important for the actual fight. Again, he lost the central line, I find the opening and I just made a big mistake. What is the mistake? I made 1, 2. But Wing Chun is designed to go straight to the point, so what I needed was 1. But this guy is good. He didn't lose the center, so he pushes the central line. And my weapon is neutralized. So I have to go to the next closest weapon, which is my elbow. I change to Bong Sao and I push him with my structure. Notice that I'm landing with my right foot in front. And this is the correct shape in order to achieve a strong structure. By having a strong structure, I might make him lose his facing and I now find another line and I have to take it. I punch him and then I close down the opposition by using a lansao. This is the lansao from the second form, which is very important for the actual fight. But because he is trained, he didn't lose the center. So, I don't find any space, so I have to remove the obstacle using a lapsao. Sorry, that was fast. But you notice how my hands immediately find any space because of good Chi Sao. So, I clear the obstacle with a lapsao and I hit him with a Fung Hao, and if he is not trained to have a Wu Sao, I cut his throat. During the lapsao, I have to retract my hand, otherwise he might make a cover and I'm fucked. I make the lapsao, he had a Wu Sao, and what is this hand doing here? It has done its job, so it should also move forward and hit him. But my partner, who is good, feels that his hand here is useless, so he needs to recover with a tansao. And while I was happy, now I'm crying because I'm in a very difficult position. But from my side, I feel it coming. I change to Bong Sao and I deflect his energy. In the language of Wing Chun, this is called a wrong bong sao, because it leaves me exposed at this area. So I immediately remember the third set of the wooden dummy form and I recover using a double palm. And of course, I always close him down with a lance out. All this analysis was included in this 5-second scenario. And this is the value of Chi Sao. You develop tools and you apply them without even thinking. And all these are applied in actual combat. Let's see how. First of all, you noticed that I improve a very strong Tan Sao linked to the rest of my body. In real circumstances, if I throw a punch linked to my body, it is very difficult for the opponent to stop it. And if he stops it, he will need to push it out of the central line. Otherwise, it is impossible. And as you saw in Chi Sao, if he pushes me out of the central line, I find another line and I take it. In real fight, it would be like that. Notice the footwork, that it is exactly the same as in Chi Sao. After this, in Chi Sao I learned that when my wrist is neutralized, I change to Bong Sao and I find another way. Many cases in which this will happen in reality, even when my opponent grabs my hand. I make a transitional Bong Sao and I find another way. In an actual fight, the opponent might stop my attack. Not very possible if I have a correct structure, but if he is a beast, yes, this might happen. So, as I have learned from Chi Sao, I use a lap saw and I find my way. The wrong bong saw is very useful when our hands cross and the opponent cannot keep his center. Again, I have learned to feel the space and I punish him. In an actual fight, it would be like this. And of course, if he keeps the center, I feel it and I use double palms. And now the lance. Whenever I find a space and I punch my opponent, it doesn't mean that he will automatically die. He might be a beast and turn and punch me back. That is why the mentality of Wing Chun is to not let him breathe. Therefore, I use the Lan Shao, the element of earth, and I close down any choice he would have. I guess you all realized how important Chi Sao is, provided that you study your game as we just explained. And now you understand why all these who make very fast movements just to pass the opponent do not develop anything. They will face an experienced fighter and they will be destroyed. Not to speak about those who don't train in Chi Sao, they don't know Wing Chun at all. We will analyze more in the next episode, so stay tuned.